Good morning. Today I just need to try and finish off fixing up the help for my Golang CLI. I ran into some problems while doing the tests, so it's obviously I haven't quite done it quite right. So let's see what state of play is. Double check that's still a thing. Yeah. So, what have we got going on here? Let's do this again. Right. So, on the config test, line 85. I'm expecting some output and not getting any for one of these new tests that I've done. And unfortunately, it's a bit of a kind of macro situation where I don't know which test is doing it because it's data driven. Now, the new ones that I've added. Well, it's only this one. Help. So doing help add should result in a help command. No. I wonder, actually, I just need to think about this. So, none of my other tests here. Have expected output, which is this last. Oh, we do at the top. Okay. But not a command. Which is correct, because we're not actually doing anything. We're not sending a command, we're not doing. I'm not doing anything bar getting help. Right, okay, I think I know. Right, yeah, I've obviously wasn't thinking straight here, I think. Okay, let's have another look at what we've got. So, we're calling this function. Config init. And we are using the subcommand help because that's the first argument. Which should mean it goes into init help flag set. Saying okay, when we display the help, we're going to use this as the usage message on the command. So it's going to be usage Snippet Pixie help command. Oh, yeah. Okay. I think we think about it, we just haven't finished it really. So it's probably correct that it's failing out. I haven't finished the job. Because I can't actually do the help here. I think. I could. I could end up refactoring this whole thing actually. What I could do is create a different flag set. I could like pass all of them, set them all up. Then based on the first argument, pluck out the one flag set to display its usage message for and stuff like that. And again, it's kind of nice to have the command structure as well, which will do a similar thing. Yeah, okay, so right, so the way I've got it working at the moment is normally if you were to do Snippet Pixie add and got it wrong in one way or another. It calls the usage function. And the changes are the flags and the options here. When you call the usage with those flags and options, which are passed with the. Flags come in and they're going to be appended here. So that's a natural display. If options are passed in, we display them. And we're assuming that if options are not displayed, entered, which is the default setup, we're going to show the full global help. Okay. kind of feel like I should make this more data-driven now. Does it compile? It does. So, Snippet Pixie on its own gives me the global help, which is okay. If I do add, I get the add commands help, which is good. But if I do help add, I get nothing because I haven't hooked it up. That's the problem. And I think I'm going to struggle. Right, well, let's assume this is what we need to call. Yeah. Kinda need to take this stuff here and put it in its own little function. So that I can call it to get the add subcommand help message effectively by passing it to usage. Think because I basically need to do this. Should go to standard out and be done. Okay, let's try this then. I need what's it going to return? What's new here? We need the flags themselves to come back. The options. We already know the app name, and out is going to be passed in, including in, this is, I'm going to be calling it from help. So we have the same thing, and out. Yeah, I don't need to do a command. What we can do is effectively this. We're doing that here, and instead of switching on args, we're going to be switching on the command. It's coming from the help. And then I'll be calling usage on out with flags and options. So we'll need to have something here like command flags. And here we'll change these up. To let's grab all these. Gonna auto all these things to be we're going to get back a command flags and options. And here we'll just do get or something. That'll do. I don't think we need to pass anything in. Other than that, we just want the flag set and kind of options intro. But we'll try it. So we'll do that. And then for each one, I've got an early stop today, so I need to be conscious of the time. But so should be able to do here, we're going to do same again. We're going to do like flags, options is equal to c.get add snippet flag set. And I'll just stick it above here. Stick this stuff in here. Oh, I should probably give it a turn. So it's going to return what's that classed as? Star, right. String. I need to do that there. I need to do that. There. So why is that complaining? That doesn't make any sense. Is this just going and not? Ah, yeah, okay. I need to tell it what version of this is. Okay. Right, okay. Let's try this then in a minute. So we are going to, so this is called get add snippet flag set. Add command. Yeah, I think that might work. Oh, of course not. It's actually setting variables in it as well. It's kind of a mixed mode there. There is another way of doing things, though, isn't there? Chrome. I had to install Chrome the other day just to use a particular website. Very annoying. Sorry, Chromium. Right. See what we've got available. I guess we'll probably have to use so you can't even do that because I'm still going to end up with a variable. Kind of need to specify what's available or what could be used. But not get it. So I could actually build them all up. So I could. Build up a whole single flag set full of flag sets. That's not enough examples. Bit of a conundrum that, because I'm going to end up with might end up just having to pass it through. Yeah, I don't know what to do here because I've got all these variables I have to set as I build up the flag set. Want to kind of do this twice. Could do a map or maps. Some other kind of structure. It's gonna be all I wanna do. Let's reuse the same flag set. This is the problem with not having written any proper Go before. I'm not used to these packages that are. Kind of inherent to Go, but I haven't used elsewhere, so. I don't know what kind of patterns they use and build up. I might have to go look at some example code, some more complex apps, and see how they deal with handling help without reinventing the wheel each time. That's a bit of a pain. Don't really want to have to pass abbreviation and body back so that I can use it. I just want to be able to look up Maybe I'm doing this wrong. Maybe what I should be doing is recognizing early on special case in help. So do a test here. If we're looking for help, then call the appropriate subcommand help message. Just basically tell it to just display help instead. Yeah. Okay, let's undo what I've just done before. So, right, what else did I do? Yeah, well, that can go. Oh, actually, I could do in here. Let me think about it. So, passing that, doing the arcs. Actually, that's going to be empty. We don't want it to actually do anything. Don't want it to go to standard error though. So, okay, let's see what we can do. Let's do something like change this. So it's going to be helpful, and then simply does if help. Just display out, display the help boy, and we're done. Maybe that should be display help just a little bit more. Useful, understandable. Do that. So that was an add. Let's do expand. We're going to do the same thing. On export, same thing. Can't do help help on the list flag, same thing. There. And then the remove, same thing. So we're just reusing what we've got. And then, so that should work there. So in the default, we're good. And then in help itself, not gonna go in a couple of minutes. So do the same format. There's no reason why you can't do help help. So keep it consistent. If it gets past that, so if it does help command, we can recurse into it actually, can't we? The do, check it, find it, do a command. Command has some length that we're going to use. And then based on that, okay, true. Oops. marks should just be... Can I put nil here? Yeah. I don't want it to do anything else. Here, we're doing help, but we're passing in display help. So it should do a one shot through that back. So coming in here, display help is false. We fall through. Do the do. Comes through. Display help is true. And we out, come out here. And we're done. Okay. That might work. So where's the problems now? Oh, yeah. So by default, on here, false. Okay. That might work. And then in the tests, when we're doing the help command, we're not actually expecting a command. So like here, it should be no command and no args. He says, is that true? Come through. Gonna do a help. Do the do. Pass the flags. Yeah, and just return nil. That's a good point. Yeah, no, we're not setting any, we're not setting config at all. That's the thing that we've avoided now. Yeah. Okay, ooh, we must go. Let's quickly switch that to no command. And no args coming back. Okay. But we do have a display. I'll give a quick run and see what damage we've done. Cool. Okay. So it's just the failing test is not failing. 1, 4, 8. Right, but I gotta go. So one of these new tests is failing. Okay, so give myself a to-do. To-do. Not failing. Okay. And then I know where I'm going to finish that off next time. Right. That's me done. Got an appointment to go off to. So until next time, take care. Bye.